For wish tenders who always have concerns of pores, we have prepared this video for you today. Hey guys, welcome back to Wish Trend TV. It's your sister Eunice here, and so glad to see every single one of you. Today, we are going to talk about pores, okay? So we're going to be talking about the must-know information about pores, to pore treatments, and how to take care of pores as well. Now, this is going to be a 3-week pore masterclass, and we're going to be uploading one video every week, so y'all got to stay tuned in. So for the very first episode, we're going to be talking about the basics. So we're going to be talking about the must-know information about pores, and also we're going to be doing pore self-diagnosis. That's going to be really fun, so stay tuned in for that. And afterwards, we're going to be talking about how to cleanse your pores as well. Personally for me, if you ask me what the most key number one important thing is about pore care, I would have to say it's cleansing. If you do the proper way of cleansing, then you can actually shorten down a lot of skin concerns related to pores as well. We're going to be telling you more tips later on, so stay tuned in. But before we move on, don't forget to subscribe to Wish Trend TV and also follow us on our Instagram. Alright, let's get started! Round 1. What causes enlarged pores? So basically, our pore is a hole where the hair comes out from. And this pathway is connected to our sebaceous glands where the sebum secretes out. Okay, so to help you understand, we have prepared the same 2 balloons here for you guys. And we're gonna blow one up first. Alright, so let's say that this is a pore clogged with sebum. Yes! So when your skin produces sebum, your pores naturally becomes wider because it has to secrete it out. So, now, if some type of waste or dead skin cells clogs the pathway like this, your pores can become even larger. Alright, so let's compare the one that we blew up to the one that we didn't. As you can see, there's a clear difference right here. So it's the same concept with our pores as well. If our pores is secreting the sebum, it is producing sebum, it is secreting it, and it repeats itself, it can become larger. There's another way that our pores can become enlarged, and it is because of reduction of collagen level. And that is gonna lack elasticity, and that can be another cause of pore enlargement as well. And I wish that pores had muscles so that it can shrink right back up, but it can't. So the most important thing also is prevention as well for your pores. And we have another amazing video about pores in Beauty Facts Unboxing Series, so please check it out right there. Round 2. Pore self-diagnosis. Shapes and sizes of pores differ depending on where it is on our face. So first of all, around the nose area on the sides is the biggest, and then it's around the cheekbone area right here, and then afterwards it is right here beginning from the top of your laugh lines to on the side of your mouth. And actually, we can categorize the shapes into 3 different ones. And you have first the O-shaped. Now, your pores of O-shaped ones are enlarged because of excessive sebum due to hormonal reasons. And U-shaped pores are caused by lack of elasticity, and this is caused by dehydration of your skin. And then we have the Y-shaped pores, and this is caused by the reduction of elastin and collagen levels on our skin. And when this happens, you know that your skin is getting thinner and weakened at the same time. Alright ladies and gentlemen, so now we are going to be doing the pore self-diagnosis. You're going to do it with me, so go get a mirror and let's try this together. Alright, so we're going to use our fingers to put it on right here on the cheekbone area and then lift a little bit. Check the before and after to see if there's a big difference or not. Now, if you see a big difference, this means that you do have a lot of vertical pores. And this means that your vertical pores are at the areas around under your eyes to the cheekbone and butterfly zone. All right, so the next one is we're gonna put our fingers right here on the corners of your lips, and then we're gonna lift up. So we're gonna lift up, we're gonna lift down. We're gonna lift up, and we're gonna lift down. Now, if you see a big difference here, this also means that you do have a lot of vertical pores around this area right here, beginning of your laugh lines to the corners of your lips. And with this one, if you don't take care of it, that means this area can actually get deepened. And then we're gonna do the third test. And we're gonna get our fingers and put it right here where the jaw actually is beginning. And we're gonna lift and put it down. Lift and put it down. And if you compare the two and you notice that there's a huge difference, this also shows that you do have a lot of vertical pores, because overall, if you do have a lot of vertical pores around the mouth area and jaw area, this can make a huge difference. Now, when it comes to taking care of your pores, we believe that clearing it out is the most important thing. So we're gonna be talking about pore cleansing, and we're gonna be doing it in round three. Round three, pore cleansing hacks. Now, we have to get rid of the sebum within our pores, but if you remove them physically or if you use force to do it, this can irritate your skin and it can have really bad results of having more excessive sebum, and in return, you're gonna have enlarged pores, even bigger and bigger. So we want to recommend that you melt the sebum, and deep cleansing with low irritation is the key, so keep that in mind. And we're going to be talking about the ultimate pore cleansing tip with uses of oils and also with wash off masks and with scrubs as well, so stay tuned in. Alright, so the very first tip is to use cleansing oils. I have heard some people say that cleansing oils did not work for them. Even worse, some people say that using cleansing oils maybe created more sebum for their skin. However, I think some people might have been using it in an improper way. So today, we're going to be sharing with you on how to properly use cleansing oils. We're going to share with you on how you can use your fingers to do it, how long you should do it for, and also the emulsification of cleansing oils as well, and even the temperature of the water. So yes, it's gonna be a fun one, so stay tuned in. First of all, let's choose a cleansing oil. Choosing the right type of cleansing oil is also very important, and we do want to recommend that you use a cleansing oil with a heavier texture because of the thick viscosity. It's gonna really help to remove the sebum much better. However, if you are like me and you just don't like the, you know, feeling of a heavy oil on your skin, you can use a lighter cleansing oil as well. Now, pump your cleansing oil 4 times. Make sure that you have sufficient amount of oil. This is very important because if you don't have enough oil, it can cause irritation because of the friction. So make sure you pump around 4 times. Apply the cleansing oil on dry skin, and first apply on the big, large areas like your forehead, and then do it across your cheek area, and then with one finger, go to your nose area, and make sure that you really take your time here because this is the area that you have the largest pores, and also imagine in your head that you're cleansing one pore by one. And keep on rolling and go to the sides, and then go to the bridge area right here, and then afterwards go to the sides of it around this area where you also have a lot of maybe vertical pores like I do, and massage for 1 minute thoroughly. Now, when you are done rolling and using the oil, you need to emulsify it. Now, what emulsification is basically when the oil meets with water, it's gonna turn more watery and white colored. So that is exactly what it is. If you don't emulsify the oil properly, this can get stuck within your pores, and this can cause a lot of skin concerns, especially like breakouts as well. So make sure that you take your time and you emulsify everything really, really thoroughly. Finally, we want to recommend that you use a foam cleanser. And it's also really important what kind of foam cleanser you use, so we do have to be very wise about it. And we want to recommend that you check out for ingredients that can help to control sebum and that helps to remove dead skin cells at the same time. For example, you have charcoal, black sugar, and also volcanic ash. Those are really good ingredients that will be very good for your pores as well. Oh, and also we want to recommend green tea, which is such an excellent ingredient that helps to control sebum, and at the same time, it gives you skin elasticity, which is an important factor as well for your pores. And one thing to remember about foam cleansers is it really doesn't matter which type you use. You can use a powder type, you can use a bar soap type, you can use a foam cleanser, whatever it may be, but you do have to foam it up really well. And one tip that we did want to share is how you can foam it up like voluptuously. And one way is for you to go like this and make sure that it foams up really well before you put it on your face. And still, if you find it a little bit difficult for you to make voluptuous foams, no worries, because we have foam makers for that, and they're very, very good price, and it's easy to make foams with it. Plus, you can also use cleansing device. This is a good method to make sure to thoroughly cleanse your pores. For the final step, make sure to rinse with lukewarm water. Second is wash off masks. And these masks are much better compared to actually sheet masks when it comes to pore care. Now, you can find any, you know, clay masks in the market or anything that you have at home, but make sure to look for ingredients like green tea or volcanic ash that can help to control sebum. And you can actually choose and decide on how often you want to use that product depending on your skin condition. And we also have an awesome video for you guys from WishTrend TV right here for you where we share how to exfoliate your skin depending on your skin type. If you want to care for your pores with ingredients that you already have at home, please try this DIY method. Get egg whites and green tea powder and a foam maker. The three things that you need. And first of all, we're gonna get the egg whites into the foam maker and foam it up. And afterwards, you're gonna add green tea and use it as a pore mask for about 10 minutes. Last but not least is scrubs. No, I don't want no scrubs. I'm just kidding. But anyways, okay, so you can choose your scrubs according to the particle sizes. And if you have sensitive skin, maybe you can choose something that has a smaller particle size. If you have oily skin, maybe you can choose something, you know, that has a larger particle size. And a lot of scrubs do have scrub as their main ingredient. And depending on your skin type and skin condition, you can choose the size of the particles. We want to recommend the black sugar scrub for oily skin types because it has a more fresh finish to it. So I think oilier skin types will really love it. And we do want to recommend the youthful sugar glow if you do have a little bit of dry or combo skin because the finish itself is much more hydrating. And fig scrubs have actually smaller particle size compared to the other scrubs that we just mentioned. So if you do have sensitive skin like myself, this is a good choice for you. And if you are kind of wondering which scrubs will fit my skin type, no worries because we have a video right here for you where we compare the scrubs. Now we're gonna be sharing two different methods that you can use these scrubs. For the first tip, you're gonna apply scrub onto your wet face and then apply gently and then wait for about 5 to 10 minutes. And when you are rinsing it off, make sure that you roll a little bit more into the areas that you want to exfoliate a little bit more. Now, another method for you guys to use scrubs, especially for you guys with sensitive skin types, is get your scrub, add a little bit of the cleansing oil, and make sure you melt it down. And this is gonna actually melt down the particles, and then we're gonna apply onto our face and massage very, very gently. And this is gonna help to remove makeup, it's gonna help to remove sebum and blackheads very gently for those of you with sensitive skin types. Alright guys, thank you so much for tuning in until the very end. Today we talked about everything you need to know about pores. First, we talked about the basic information, and second, we did pore self-diagnosis, and third, we talked about how to cleanse your pores as well. Before the second episode, make sure to try out the tips that we talked about today, and also for the second episode, we're going to be sharing ingredients and products that are really good for pore care. So stay tuned in, make sure to comment below, subscribe, like, and we will see you in the next one. Bye, WishTrenders!